Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be all of my favorite high-end makeup products in 2016. So I'm going to be sharing with you a lot of products that I have talked about through 2016. I think I've probably talked about most of them, but these are like the best of the best. Now these aren't everything I've been loving in 2016 because that video would be like 3 hours long and I had to narrow it down. So there are a lot of products that I love that I'm not mentioning, but these are like the best of the best. If my makeup collection were to disappear tomorrow, what would I go out and buy first? You know, what do I really use and love immensely. So that's what I picked out today, and I will be doing a drugstore version of this video as well coming up in the next few days, so keep your eyes out for that. But I wanted to start with high-end. I have a ton of products that I'm going to be talking about today, so let's get right into it. Let's start with primers. So the first primer that I want to talk about is the Too Faced Hangover RX Primer. I discovered this like midway through the year, I think towards the end of the year, and it's one that I had wanted to try for so long, and I finally did, and I just love it. Now this is the, it's not the sample size, but it's like the half size that I got at Ulta for, I think, $11 or something, just because I wanted to try it out before I got the full size, but I am definitely going to go get the full size. Like, I think I'm going to have to go to Ulta to buy some hair products this week, so I'm going to probably get a full size of this because I love it so much. This one's almost out. It's just amazing. It is unlike any primer, honestly, I've ever tried before. It's moisturizing and hydrating, but it also creates a sort of, not sticky base, but a nice base for your makeup to go on really smoothly and to stay on, and it feels nourishing, and that's another reason why I really love it, is that it just feels so good, especially in these drier winter months. My skin has been getting so dry lately. This just helps it so much, so I really, really love this primer. I also love the packaging. It has a pump, which I think is so cool. So just loving this stuff. The other primer I want to talk about is kind of a completely different product, even though it is a primer, and this is the Tarte Clean Slate Timeless Smoothing Primer. So rather than putting this all over my entire face, I actually wear both of these primers in conjunction with each other. I'm wearing them both today. After I put on my Too Faced Hangover RX primer, I put on the Tarte one, and I heard Stephanie Nicole refer to it as a spackle, and that's a really good word. It's like a product that literally like fills in holes. Like, you know how you spackle your walls to like cover up nail holes and stuff? That's exactly what this does. Like, it fills in the pores, and you just take a little bit of it on your finger, and then I have recently discovered that rubbing it upwards, I think Nicole Guerrero taught me that, rubbing it upwards actually gets it into the pores better than pushing it down. So I actually kind of push it upwards, and I don't rub too much because I don't want to rub it away, but just kind of push it up into the pores this way, and it fills the pores in magically, and it is just such a good pore filling primer, and it makes the skin look smoother. But again, I only use this where I have pores, so like right here is the main area, and then also up here a little bit, down here a little bit. I don't put it on my whole face. I don't think it's necessary for that. And because I only use it on those small areas, this is gonna last me a really long time. So again, love this one. Now moving on to foundation, I actually have three foundations that I want to talk about. Each foundation is very different and they do different things, so that's why I have three, but they are three that I've really been loving. So the first one is probably my all-time favorite, at least as of right now, what I'm wearing today, and that is the Urban Decay All Nighter Foundation. This is a full coverage mattifying foundation. Now, don't be scared away, because like I said, I have had dry skin lately and I still love this foundation, even though it is mattifying. It's not painfully mattifying. It's not like cracking on the skin. I don't set it with a lot of powder, but I did set it with a little bit of powder, and I still really love it. I love the finish. It feels very natural to me. I am in the shade 7.75. Again, this is a full coverage. This is probably the most full coverage foundation I have ever tried. Not that I've tried that many high-end foundations. I've tried a handful of them, but this is definitely like the best full coverage foundation that I've ever tried. So that is what I love this for. I wear it every day, but you know, if you don't want full coverage every day, you don't have to wear it every day. I don't mind it. I kind of enjoy it. The only downside to this foundation, I like the packaging, but I feel like it's running out really quickly, and that could just be because I love it so much. I've been using it a lot more than I normally would, but I feel like it's already almost half gone, right? I mean, yeah, I don't know. That's a little bit of a bummer because I love it so much. I'm definitely going to repurchase it. I wish it lasted a little bit longer, but I guess that's just the nature of the foundation. So yes, this has definitely been a favorite in 2016. The next one I have is my medium coverage foundation, or more of like the everyday wear foundation. This is my Arbonne Perfecting Liquid Foundation. This has been a favorite since before I started YouTube. I've loved this foundation. This was the first sort of high-end foundation I ever tried. I love this one because it It has a very beautiful natural finish. It's really easy to apply and it is slightly buildable. I wouldn't say that you could build it up to a full coverage, but you can get like a light medium to medium full coverage depending on how you build it up, which is really nice in a foundation to be able to build it and add layers and not have it get icky. That's always a plus. This packaging is actually very similar to this packaging. It feels like they have this kind of bottle in here. It's airtight, which means it comes from the bottom up, so you don't end up wasting any, or you end up wasting very, very little. That's so important with foundation. If you're gonna pay for a high-end foundation, you don't want to waste it. You don't want to be breaking the bottles or scraping out the bottles. That's so frustrating. So I love the packaging of this, and it's really nice simple packaging too. There is 1 fluid ounce in here, and this also has SPF of 15, which I really like because for an everyday foundation it's just that extra sun protection. Because it has that SPF, I wouldn't recommend it for like special occasions or photography or anything, or at least test it out before you rely on it for a special occasion, but it's great for every day. I really love this foundation. I also like this foundation because all of the ingredients are all natural, it's all vegan, so you don't have to worry about wearing it every day. It's not gonna be bad for your skin, it's breathable, really great foundation. I have 2 shades because this is the first time in my life I've gotten too light for my normal shade, which is deep beige. I don't know, it must be the winter, I don't know, but I'm golden beige right now in the winter, so that's why I have 2 shades here. But yes, love this one. And then the last foundation I want to talk about is the Urban Decay Naked Skin Foundation. This is the Weightless Ultra Definition Liquid Makeup. It is basically a light coverage foundation. This has good coverage though, don't get me wrong, but I can see some of my like natural imperfections through. I feel like it definitely neutralizes things, but it's just, there's like, if I look really closely, I can see stuff through this foundation, which is okay. This is actually what I wore on my wedding because it does not have SPF in it, and it's a very natural, very beautiful finish. It looks like skin. It looks like you're not wearing any makeup, and that was my goal for my wedding, was to look very natural and not look like it was too caked on, you know, because I was gonna be wearing it for like over 12 hours. So I wanted a very natural look, and I really like this one. It's very lightweight. It's very liquidy too when you put it on. It's not like a cream like the other two. It almost like drips away. You have to kind of be careful. But this is a really good like light, natural, no makeup look, everyday foundation as well. For concealer, I just have one because this one has stood out hands down, without a doubt, the best thing that has happened to me in the concealer world in 2016, and that is the Tarte Shape Tape. Yes, I know everybody's talking about it for good reason. This is amazing. It's just amazing. It's unreal. I have the shade medium, and I just love it. I love the coverage. I'm wearing it today. I wear it primarily under my eyes, and then I will take the excess on my beauty blender and put it on the high points of my face, but I don't apply this to the high points of my face. This stuff is very, very thick, and a little bit goes a long, long way. So that's really nice. The applicator is huge, which is kind of confusing, but I don't mind it. I kind of like that. It just makes it, I don't know, it makes it even more fun to apply. It has a really nice light scent to it. It's kind of like, I think it's citrusy, but it's also kind of florally. So I don't really know how to describe the scent, but it's scented. And I don't know, I just really, really love this concealer. It has been an absolute favorite. I'm never going to stop repurchasing this. The next thing I do in my routine is set my under eye concealer after I apply the concealer. And with that, I have been loving the Lorac Pro Contour Palette. This is a good palette in general. I like this contour palette, but the under eye yellow setting powder right here, you can see I've hit pan on it. I love it so much. It's perfect because it's so finely milled that I don't feel like I can ever see powder under my eyes. Like, I could go heavy-handed, which I don't really, but you could go heavy-handed and you still don't see the powder under your eyes. You know, you just kind of pat it under the eye and it just disappears, but it sets the concealer so that the concealer doesn't crease and it lasts longer. I also really love the tone of yellow. I feel like it's a nice, I don't know how to describe it, I just feel like of all the yellow setting powders I have, this is the best one. So that's that. The contour powders in here and the other powders in here are nice too. I especially like the light contour and the medium contour, but I don't know that it's my favorite contour palette for contouring, if that makes sense, but I do use them, especially like now that I've hit pan, I'm trying to use these other ones up as well. But overall, the yellow is just my absolute favorite in here. So it'd be nice if they made them, like, if they sold each shade separately, that'd be really nice, because I would just buy that one. Next, for all over the face setting powder, I have been loving the Too Faced Primed and Poreless Pressed Powder. I love the packaging of this. It is so adorable and fun to use. Again, I've hit pan on it. Now you can see this one is not stark white. It is translucent, but it has a little bit of a tint to it, like a nude-ish tint to it, which I didn't really realize until I was comparing it to my Milani one, which is white. This one is a little bit off-white, and that might be why I like it, although I like my Milani one too, but this one is so finely milled and just so super fine that it's really fantastic. It doesn't show up on the skin at all. It doesn't leave a white cast, and it doesn't look powdery either, and that's why I love it. So this has been a definite favorite in 2016. I'd say bronzer was the hardest category for me to narrow down because I have so many contour palettes and so many single bronzers that I rotate through that it's really hard for me to pick just one in each category. And the ones that I use the most are actually drugstore, so I'll be talking about those in my best of drugstore video. But I do have one that I have been loving nonstop, and that is the Arbonne Bronzer. I love this bronzer because it is very versatile. You can do a little bit of contouring with it. It has a slight shimmer to it, but it's not intense enough that you can't contour with it. You can do a light contour with it, but it's really good for warming up the face because of that shimmer. It just adds a nice, beautiful glow to the skin. I am wearing it today. I like to put it in this area and kind of just draw it all around the outer parts of my face. I feel like it really warms up the face. It has a little bit of like a warm, I don't know if it would be, I wouldn't call it orangey, and you can't even really see in the swatch, but it's just the perfect shade for me. I really enjoy it. Also, it's a drier formula and it's firmly packed so that you don't get too much on your brush at a time. And in that way, it's really good for beginners. If you're just getting into bronzing, if you don't really know where to start, I love recommending this product to people because I feel like you can go with a heavy hand and you can't really go wrong with it. I literally feel like you could just put this all over your entire face if you really wanted to, and it would still look good. Next for brows, I have two products that I want to talk about. One, I realized I forgot to put in my box here, but I'll show you a picture of it. It's the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. That is still the best brow gel, clear brow gel, that I have ever tried. I know it's high-end, it's expensive. I do feel like it lasts a really long time, though, and I'm not sure why that is, but I just feel like I had a sample size that lasted me over a year, and now I have a full size that is going strong. Like, I'm sure it's gonna last me a really long time, so that's definitely a huge plus. But I love the clear brow gel just for setting my brows, and then for a more natural brow look, I've really been loving this Arbonne Shape It Up Brow Pencil. This is a double-ended product, so it has the pencil here, which twists up, which is so nice, and then it has a spoolie on this end. And I did use this product today with a tinted brow gel from the drugstore that I'll talk about in my next video, but the tip is kind of dull, like you can, not dull, but yeah, that's dull, right? Like, it's thick, which it's not pointed, but it actually works out because what I use this for is I just put this on like the bottom here of my brows, and then I take the spoolie and I comb it upwards, and it blends out really, really well. And I think that's the most important thing. And sometimes with a really pointy tip, you almost get too much precision and too much intensity and you can't blend it out. So I really like this one. I think if you do your brows like me, it'll work. If you do your brows differently where you like draw in the hairs more, you might not like it as much, but I really have been loving this, especially for the really kind of natural brow look. Okay, after I do my brows, I usually move on to eyes. I don't have a favorite high-end eyeshadow primer because I have a favorite drugstore one. I have a few high-end eyeshadow primers, but that I use and that I like, but none of them have like jumped out to me as like must-haves, absolutely need them, you guys need to go buy them. Like, I don't feel like I have any high-end primers that are like that, so I'm not going to talk about any eyeshadow primers. But I do have three eyeshadow palettes to talk about. This was probably the hardest thing in the world to narrow down. I could have kept adding and adding and adding, but I really picked the ones that I feel like not only that I reach for the most, but also that I feel like I can do the most with. So like ones that I would take traveling, ones that I would, like, again, go out and buy if all of my makeup disappeared. You know, these are the ones that I really like the most. And I also tried to pick ones that are available now that weren't limited edition or that are, but are still for sale so that you guys can get them if you want to. So the first one is the Lorac Pro 3 palette. This is the perfect neutral palette. I mean, I feel like I use this palette a lot for really neutral, natural, everyday looks. I'm wearing it today and I'm wearing a lot of the matte shades, and I just love the matte shades. I don't know what it is. I love these two right here. I love Terracotta, Cool Taupe. I mean, all of them. I love them all. I love the shimmery ones. The only one I don't really like in this palette is Medallion, because it's like really chunky. I don't know if you can see that. It's weird. I don't know. But all the other ones are amazing. Light Gold is so pretty. So pretty. Amethyst. Rose Bronze. Like, they're so pretty. And if you guys haven't tried Lorac shadows, they're so smooth and so just buttery and super pigmented, super high quality. The mattes are fantastic and the shimmers are fantastic. And it's hard to find a palette where you have both of those that are the same quality. You know what I mean? A lot of times, like, a brand will be really good at one or the other, but not both. And Lorac is so good at both. They're very powdery, but I don't mind that. They're very high quality and it's worth it. So definitely recommend this palette and Lorac shadows in general if you haven't tried them yet. The next palette I want to talk about is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette. This is another one that a lot of people have on their favorites list for good reason. This is such a great palette. It's so versatile. There's so much you can do. Every time I look at this palette, I think of a different look that I could do. That's how versatile it is. It's just, she hit it out of the park with this palette. It is fantastic and the quality is amazing. I love the matte shades that she chose. She's got your, you know, crease shades, your simple everyday matte shades where you can just get an everyday matte look. And she's got the pinky ones and the orange ones and these more neutral but still really warm toned. Pretty Primavera is such a pretty inner corner highlight. And even this like cooler, I don't know, I just love it. I just, everything she did, it's amazing. It's absolutely amazing for the amount of shadows in here. It feels like you're getting like 30 shadows in here with the variety that you can do with this palette. I really love it. And again, the quality is amazing. Anastasia is another one of those brands that has really, really good quality eyeshadows. So I love this palette. And the last eyeshadow palette I am happy to talk about, I am happy that I can talk about it, and that is the Too Faced Sweet Peach eyeshadow palette. This has without a doubt been a favorite throughout the year. I had to stop talking about it for a while because they sold out so very quickly, and I don't want to talk about things that you guys can't buy, you know, I think that that's kind of mean. But it's back now, and I've seen it at, I think Macy's it's in stock, I've seen it at a few different places where it is in stock, so I just jumped at the chance to talk about it. But this is such a beautiful palette, kind of like the Anastasia palette. Every time I look at this, I think of new looks, new things I could do. It smells like fake peaches, but it smells nice, and it kind of brings me back to like the spring when I first got it. You know how that is, like when you have a smell that you smelled a lot all the time, and then you smell it like months later and it brings you back? That's how I feel. I love the shades in here. Again, it has the most beautiful. Again, it has the most beautiful inner corner highlight. This is the most beautiful brow bone highlight, Nectar here. And then all of these shades are just so fun. It's such a fun variety. Like, you have this like shimmery green, you have purples, you have tons of neutrals and browns, you have just everything. I don't know. It's just such a great palette. I love it so much. And I want to try their new face. Ow. And I want to try their new face palette, and they have a new blush too. I want to try those as well, but if you have to pick one thing from the collection, I still think this is the way to go. I have another face product that I forgot to mention before that is a setting powder. It's actually a setting powder palette. This is the Too Faced No Filter Selfie Powder palette. Selfie powders. They are light filtering photo enhancing powders. They're called selfie powders because if you look at the picture there, it's designed to like be like Instagram filters. I don't know about that, but I really like this palette. I've been reaching for it a lot lately, and I know people have really mixed opinions on it because they don't really know how they're supposed to use it, but I use them literally as setting powders, and I go for whatever my current look is. So like today, I felt like my look was pretty warm, so I went with the Sunrise Yellow shade, and that's the one I go with the most because I feel like that looks the best in my skin tone, I guess. But if, let's say I have a really cool toned eye, but then I feel like my skin is looking a little bit too warm for the cool toned eye, I'll take this purple one and I'll set my face with it. Or you can use it as a finishing powder too. It doesn't have to be a setting powder. I've done both ways, but this will add a little bit of a cooler tone to my skin. So I really love it. And then of course this one can just add like that warmer bronzing tone to the skin. So I just really like this palette. I don't think it's talked about enough. I don't know if it's all in my head. Maybe it's really not doing anything. I don't know, but I really enjoy using this palette. So it's a super fun one and I do recommend it if you think that you'd be into like the filtering finishing powder kind of a deal. For mascara, I have one and one only. Now, I have been starting to fall in love with other mascaras, but I wouldn't say I love them to the point that they'd be like a yearly favorite just yet. So I do love other mascaras, but this one is still my all-time go-to, love it, and that's the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. I feel like this just coats the lashes, it thickens the lashes, it lengthens the lashes, it makes it look like I have 15 times more lashes than I have, and it's just so beautiful. This is what I wear when I'm not wearing fake lashes. Today I am actually wearing fake lashes. I'm trying it out, it's part of my New Year's resolution, but I don't wear this with fake lashes because it's too volumizing and it just looks a little like too much, but I use this every day when I'm not wearing fake lashes. I literally, it's just my go-to. I love it so much. I like the waterproof version too, but not as much as this one. I feel like this one is still the best. Next, for blushes, I have quite a few to talk about, again, of course. First, I want to talk about the Urban Decay Afterglow Blush. I have a couple of these, but this shade is Fetish, and this is the most beautiful, perfect, everyday shade. I feel like I always pick out my favorite blush to be in this, like, sort of mauve, berry-toned family, but the other blushes I have are actually kind of different, so that's a good thing. But yes, I love this one. It looks great on my skin tone, a little bit darker, and it's just such a good quality. It's what I'm wearing today, and it's just so pretty. I love it. I want to get more of these. I love these blushes. I love the packaging. It's so simple and cute and thin, and I just love it. They're called the Afterglow 8-Hour Powder Blush, and I do feel like these last all day. Next, I have the Makeup Geek blush. This is in the shade XOXO, a little bit brighter shade here. In 2016, Makeup Geek launched a bunch of new colors from their blushes, and I think that they reformulated them a little bit too, but I'm not sure about that. But I got this one in a BoxyCharm, and I love it. I love the packaging because it has a little mirror, and again, it's just really nice, sleek, thin packaging, really lightweight, and I love the color, and I love the formula. It is soft, but it's not too soft. It's very pigmented, and it's just a really fun color too for like a little bit more of get you noticed, but it blends out so well, and these last really well too. So really loving this one. Next, I have to give a shout out to my Arbonne blushes. I have a ton of these as well, and these have been a favorite for a while, not just in 2016, but even before that. This is in the shade Dusty Rose. So this is even more of a neutral, everyday, barely there kind of a blush, but it is so beautiful. Their blushes are so nice, and they have a really nice variety of matte and shimmery blushes, which I really enjoy. This is just, again, that really pretty, natural, barely there. It has a teeny tiny little bit of shimmer in it when I'm looking at it in the light, but I don't feel like you can see that at all on the face. It's just really beautiful. Love the Arbonne blushes. Next, I have the Too Faced Sweethearts blush in the shade Sparkling Bellini. It came out when the Sweet Peach palette came out in the spring, but I'm pretty sure it's still for sale. I don't think this was limited edition. I love this one, especially for spring and summer. I'm really excited to bust this back out this spring because it just has the perfect, like, glowy, springy, peachy vibe to it. And like I said, I want to try the other Too Faced new face products they came out with, but I'm not in a big hurry to because I just love this one so much that I feel like this does whatever I could ever want in like a peachy blush. You know, it has a shimmer and it has the glow and it's really beautiful. It actually has three stripes there if you can see, and if you want to, it's designed well enough that you can get a brush in just one of the colors, or you can just sort of focus on one of the colors and get really three blushes out of it. But I usually mix them all together. But anyways, I just really love it. And then the packaging, I mean. Okay, to segue from blush into highlighter, I want to talk about this palette. This is the Becca Jaclyn Hill, what is this called? Champagne Collection Face Palette. Now, this was sold out, but I'm pretty sure they brought it back. I'm not 100% sure if it's still available or if it's sold out, but I want to talk about it anyways because I want to talk about the individual shades, which I believe are for sale. So okay, so these blushes are fantastic. Amaretto is probably my all-time favorite everyday natural blush, but I love all of these a lot. And then the highlighters. Okay, Champagne Pop has got to be one of my favorites from 2016. I used it a ton. However, when this palette came out, I honestly think Prosecco Pop right here may have topped Champagne Pop. Like, I still love Champagne Pop, don't get me wrong, but Prosecco Pop, I feel like it's a little bit better and more unique on my skin tone. It feel like, that's what I'm wearing today, I feel like it's just the gold in it really brings out something on my skin, and it's a little bit, I don't know, I just really, really love it. So both of these highlighters I really, really, really love. Highlighters was another one that was really hard for me to narrow down because I do have a ton of favorites, but I would have to say the Becca ones, and then Anastasia Beverly Hills are my other favorite highlighters. The glow kits are so fantastic. If you guys haven't tried one of these yet, I highly recommend that you do. They're $40 for these ones. They have an ultimate glow kit now that is $45, I think, with 6 shades and a mirror. It's a little bit different, but these ones are still my all-time favorite. I have the one in Sweets here today, but I really like all of them. I like Sweets because I feel like it's kind of one of the more versatile ones. It has this fun, different purple shade, this really nice marshmallow shade that can transform any of these to work for lighter skin, but this on its own looks really good on my skin as well. Also, Taffy is a really good sort of blush or blush topper. I've worn it as just blush or a blush topper before, and then Butterscotch is a fun, sort of a more classic highlighter shade. So I really like this palette, but again, any of the glow kits, I highly recommend this. These ones, the 4 pans without the mirrors, come with removable pans too, which is an extra bonus, because if you travel with a Z palette, you can pop one of these out, put them in your Z palette, or if you have a bunch of these glow kits, you can mix and match with, you know, you could take like some of these out and put some others from a different glow kit in here, you know what I mean? So it's very versatile in that way. So I really love these. For the price, I mean, how much is a Becca highlighter? Like, a single Becca highlighter is like $30-something, isn't it? And if you think about that, you're getting like pretty much a full-size highlighter. You're getting 4 of them in here for $40. It's such a good deal. Such a good deal. If you haven't got one yet, go get you one. And then I also wanted to talk about the Moonchild palette because it is so unique and fun. It's just look at that. Like, now this is not going to be everyone's cup of tea, but it's such a fun, special palette that I had to mention it. It's so fun to have on hand for someone like me who, like, I consider myself a makeup artist. I mean, maybe not officially, but I think that I am. Someone who likes to experiment with different tones and colors and just different looks in general. This is really a nice palette to have. It's really special. So I like it. And it's kind of full of surprises. Like, you swatch Blue Ice right here, it's called Blue Ice. You don't really know what to expect, and then it's like so blue. Look at that. And like Pink Heart right here, it's got this like pink and white duochrome. It's so cool. These are just so much fun. I mean, a green highlighter, you guys. Okay, when I'm done with my whole face except for lips, I set my face and my setting powder. No. The setting spray that I have been loving in 2016 is the Urban Decay Chill Makeup Setting Spray. The reason that I especially love this one is because it is cooling and hydrating, but it's not like oily. It doesn't make your skin look oily or yucky in that kind of a way, because I often think of a setting spray as something that I want to almost like dry up my skin, but like hairspray, you know, like it's gonna set on there and then it's gonna just melt everything together, make everything stay. I don't think of it as something that I want to leave like a oily, dewy residue necessarily, and this doesn't, but it is hydrating and it is cooling. So I love this for that, especially in the winter months. I don't feel like I'm drying out my skin more. And I also like this one because you can use it throughout the day. Like, if I've had my makeup on for a few hours and it's feeling dry and icky, I can spray this on it and it kind of gives you that refreshing, cooling feeling without messing up your makeup. As you can see, I lost the cap to it, so that's how much I love it. Okay, let's move on to lips. I have a bunch of lippies to talk about, and I'm actually going to be talking about like lip formulas in general that I like, and I do have some of my favorite colors here, but I'm not talking about like just the color. I'm talking more about the formula in general that I really like. So the first lip products that I want to talk about is this one quickly. This is a Too Faced Melted Liquid Lipstick. These are not new, and these are not a new favorite for me either. I've loved these since before 2016, but I've loved them a lot in 2016, and particularly this one. This is the Melted Fig shade. This is to die for. I love this shade so much, so I just wanted to give this a quick shout out. New in 2016 is the Too Faced Melted Matte Liquid Lipsticks, and these have been a huge hit. I love these a lot. I cannot wait for them to come out with more colors. I'm surprised they haven't already, honestly, but I love this. The one I have here is Queen Bee, and this is a matte liquid lipstick, but it is not super matte. Like, it's not super drying. It's not 100% transfer proof either. Once it dries, you can eat and drink, but it will come off a little bit. You will need to reapply it. It does layer well though, which is a huge plus. And I don't know, I just really like these. I feel like they're really natural, and because they're not super drying and super matte, I feel like it makes them more wearable. So really love these. Then I have a liquid lipstick from Anastasia Beverly Hills. I have fallen in love with their liquid lipsticks this year as well. This is in the shade Kathryn. That's what I'm wearing today. I love the formula of these. Now, these are more drying than the Too Faced ones, so you definitely want to make sure that you are wearing a lip balm underneath, but they last a little bit longer because of that, and they don't transfer as much, and I just think they're so pretty. I think her color selection is really fantastic. That's one thing I love about her products and her everything that Anastasia has, because that's an amazing brand. That's probably my favorite brand of 2016, honestly. But I love the color selection. They're just really fun, nice colors, and really good quality products. So loving these liquid lipsticks. Moving on to more glossy type things, I want to talk about the Anastasia Beverly Hills Lip Glosses. Again, this is just the full-size shade that I have in Fudge, but I have a bunch of their minis that came in their like summer kit. They have fall kits of like 6 different minis. I recommend these so much because not only is it a really good gloss, it's super good coverage. So it's like, look at that, like super opaque. Feels so nice, has a really nice scent, which is always a plus. And yeah, it just feels so nice in the lips. It looks so nice. It sits really nicely. It's not sticky. It doesn't settle into the fine lines or bleed at all. It just looks beautiful. I absolutely love these glosses, so I highly recommend Anastasia Beverly Hills lip glosses. Now, if you're looking for a lip gloss that is maybe not as intense as that, as far as pigmentation goes, I really love the Buxom lip glosses. Now, these ones do have a little bit of a plumping aspect to them, so they tingle a little bit when you put them on the lips. Not bad, though, at all. It's really nice. The shade I have here is Sugar, and these ones are also really nice because they have really sparkly shades. Not all of the shades are sparkly, but a lot of them are. You can see the sheen in that one. So this is nice if you just want to add some sparkle to your already done lip look, or you know, whatever you have. But again, these are a little bit kind of minty, tingly, but not painful and not too harsh at all, in my opinion anyways. So really like these lip glosses. And then the last product I kind of picked out at the last minute because I wasn't going to talk about it because I guess it's not new to me. Like, I got this at the beginning of 2016, I think, so I wasn't thinking of it as like really a something that I should talk about, but I reach for this all the time, and this is the Manicazar Beauty Simplified. I think it's just called a lip gloss. That's all it says on here, though. This is in the shade Lucky. Love the packaging on this. It's like rectangular, which is super fun, and this is just what it looks like. Now, like I said, I think it's a lip gloss, but to me, it's more like a liquid lipstick. It's kind of like the Anastasia lip glosses in the sense that it's so pigmented and opaque that it's more like a liquid lipstick that doesn't dry matte. You know what I mean? So that's that. And the shade is just perfect for me too. Like, this is something that I'll reach for when I am, if I'm traveling and I don't know what lippies I want to bring with me, I'll always throw this in. If I'm running out the door and I don't have time to like think about what lippies I want, I will throw this on. I mean, this is just like my go-to, really perfect everyday color for me. So I have really been loving this one, so I had to mention it. Okay guys, that is it for my best of high-end beauty of 2016. Those are all of the like top of the top products that I've been loving in 2016. I hope that you guys found this video interesting and helpful. I would love to hear what your favorite high-end products of 2016 are. I'm always looking to try new things and find new gems, so definitely let me know in the comment section below what your favorite products have been in 2016. Make sure you're subscribed. Like I said, I will be doing my best of drugstore 2016 very soon, possibly not till next week, but pretty soon. And if you did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up because that helps other people to find me in the YouTube world. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate you all very much, and I will talk to you again very soon.